Well, on a much more serious note, harness racing lost its biggest star during the week. An absolute tragedy that Vin Knight died during the week. It's strange when you think that he had fulfilled so much in his sport, yet he felt unfulfilled in life. Vin will be remembered by all of us that knew him, that had some sort of connection with him, as a great guy, a larger-than-life figure, and here's a small tribute to him.
The Vin Knight legend is well-founded. 36 when he died, he was still a youngster in the world of harness racing, and VJ rewrote the book. In less than two decades, Knight drove 707 Metropolitan winners, and in the 84-85 season, he won the Australian Driving Championship. Six times, Vinnie drove a century in a season, and he won the Victorian Premiership on five occasions. In 1989, Vin and his father, Bob, combined to win races worth $2.5 million, an astonishing figure considering the relative amounts of prize money available in harness racing compared to the thoroughbreds. It was in the big stadium that Vinnie was at his best. It's a paradox that he didn't win the greatest race, the Inter-Dominion, as a driver, because in so many ways, Vinnie dominated the Inter. He drove in 10 consecutive finals, winning a record 18 heats, including a couple for square gaiters. Twice in the final, he pulled the wrong rein, Bag Limit instead of Our Maestro, and then the following year, Our Maestro, when Jody's Babe won. He drove a number of wonderful horses, including Sinbad Bay, Gary's Advice, Smooth Falcon, Bag Limit, and Our Maestro, and the daddy of them all, Popular Arm. Harness racing has its share of super horses, Captain Sandy, Cardigan Bay, Howe Wears, Pure Steel, and Paleface Adios, but Poppy is probably the best ever.
Then Laskin, but he must be the greatest in the world, straightening up Popular Arm. He's streaked away. He's five lengths in front of Gemmelite, then Raw three, and then Laskin. But look at this mighty horse go up the home straight. Possibly the world's greatest, Popular Arm, 20 metres in front of Gemmelite. Then Raw three, followed further back by Fearless Kick. But welcome back, Poppy. You've done it again. Popular Arm streaking away for the Winfield Cup. 20 metres to Gemmelite. Third home is Raw three.
But for all the stats, Vinnie's lasting quality was his personality. Larger than life, Vin was his sport's biggest star. And in 100 years, when the fans talk and reminisce about trotting, Vin Knight will still be the centre of attention. Yes, Vinnie was a rarity. He's one of the few sports people who, quite honestly, is irreplaceable.
Miss that smile, Jack, aren't we?
Well, we certainly are, Bruce. I'm an unabashed fan of harness racing, and I'm an unabashed fan of that man. And you know, he's left a great void in the game, because I'm very critical of the trotting powers to be, because one of the things that I think has seen the demise of trotting is a lack of publicity, you know, in the newspapers and in the electric media. And Vin Knight is genuinely one person in the game who had the ability to get his name in the newspaper or on the news. And it was just a great tragedy for me to see the guy go out that way. I mean, I played golf with him. I've watched his horse. He had to scratch the horse in Auckland in New Zealand, Bag Limit, when it probably would have won the final. Great tragedy and a great shame for the game of trotting. We really are going to be in trouble for big stars in trotting without Vin Knight.
Oh, he was irreplaceable, and he's a great mate to all of us. Well, that's it for racing and for trotting this week. Jack, thanks for coming in. Really enjoyed your company today.
You're welcome,
and
Bruce.
You too, Keith.
Thanks, Bruce. I'll see you next week, as long as Jack's not back. I always feel underdressed when Jack's the bear with the bow tie.
And he's such a good-looking bloke too, Keith.
He is too, yeah. Scratch him, will you?
I will. We'll take a break.